week's WealthTrack guest has been analyzing Washington's impact on the financial markets for nearly three decades. He is widely respected financial thought leader Tom Gallagher, who has been named an all-star analyst by Institutional Investor magazine for 17 years, including the last seven when he and his team have been ranked number one. I visited Tom in his Washington office and asked him to describe some of the major changes occurring in Washington, starting with the government's response to the financial crisis.
It's got to be the most intense time of my career. It has to be the time where Washington played the biggest role that it has in the financial markets. I think it also happens to come at a turning point in these long cycles in the role of government in the economy. It happens to have happened at a time when you had a swing toward a more activist government. So I think it's hugely important, and it's really the framework that I'm using to think about all the investment decisions. You know, was the policy response appropriate? I think it was, and I think the markets are more or less telling you that it was. It was appropriate in the sense that you had a panic, and the government had to get rid of the panic. It did so with this alphabet soup of facilities that at the bottom, at the core, transferred risk from the private sector to the public sector. And then you had massive policy stimulus to try to avoid the depression. It worked, but now you've got to deal with the next phase of it, which is dealing with the fiscal side. But that's the framework that I'm using to think about the challenges the policy response is presenting to the investment outlook.
So let's talk about this, because I mean, you're a historian as well. You love to look at the past and see what patterns that we're observing. And one of the things that you've said, one of your theories has been that the 2008 election of President Obama is the reverse of the 80 election of President Reagan. Right. So tell us why that is and why it's so significant.
Sure. My tagline was that 08 was the reverse of 80. You know, use a little numerology to make the point that just as the 1980 election accelerated the move toward a more limited government agenda, and we identified that with Reagan, I think the 08 election has accelerated the move toward a more activist role for government in the economy. And it's just this, it's really a notion that you get these long swings in the role of government in the economy. You don't have a stable role for government. They tend to move in one direction and then stop and then move in the other direction. You get some initial successes from the shift, as we did with Reagan and as I think we are now. But then you get excesses for moving in that direction, and you get unmet needs. You know, in this case, I think it's the environment, labor market issues, areas where the public has a desire to see a more activist role for government. So I think that the 08 election is a parallel to 1980 in that important sense. I also think that the first year and a half of the Obama administration looks a lot like the first year and a half, 2 years of the Reagan administration, in that you have a correction in that swing in the mood. In 1982, the Republicans had a really bad midterm election, in part because you had double-digit unemployment during the election year. The Republicans lost 27 House seats on a proportionate basis. That would be a 34-seat loss for Democrats now. So Democrats in 1982 didn't think that Reagan was ushering in a second term, let alone a new era. So they went with their core, and they went with Mondale, who won a state in 1984. So I think you see a rough parallel now. I'm not saying that's the script, but I think you could see something similar. Republicans are going to have a great midterm this year. They may draw the wrong lessons. It's probably due more to the economy than to the policy agenda. I'm not saying that Obama will come back and have the kind of landslide that Reagan did, because I think that the economy over the next 2 years isn't going to be as robust as it was, say, in the end of Reagan's first term. But I just see a lot of parallels there, a lot of lessons to be learned about the role of government and even about the electoral outlook.
One of the things that you've said on a recent WealthTrack, which really surprised me, actually, and I think it was that people overrate the risks that Washington can pose to the markets.
Right. I've been here in Washington for over 30 years now, and everybody thinks that the rest of the country pivots off what happens in Washington. And I just think that's not the case. You know, that you put it in perspective. I think that's one of the things I've tried to do over time, is to put Washington in its proper perspective in terms of the overall investment outlook, and not exaggerate the importance of either the positives or the negatives coming out of Washington.
So what should we as investors be watching coming out of Washington? What are the things that we really do need to pay attention to?
It's how the Fed handles the challenge of withdrawing the stimulus now that a recovery seems to have taken hold. It's how Washington deals with the major fiscal challenges of bringing the medium and long run deficits under control in a timely way. I think that you look at the financial reform because that sets the rules of the game for the financial sector, both in terms of what its impact is in the economy near term, but also to prevent another bubble from occurring. A lot of people would get nervous right now that interest rates are at zero and the rules haven't really changed yet. So some people are nervous that another bubble could develop. Maybe it will, but it's probably going to be abroad, not in the U.S. So I think those are the key things to monitor in Washington.
Tom Gallagher, so great to have you once again in WealthTrack.
Thank you.